Hello! What's up, guys? Milo here, again, with another KR Panaw tutorial. I saw a request about adding sounds or audio to a virtual tour, so that's what we're gonna do today. I'm gonna show you some samples. I'm not gonna talk after because the audio is gonna cover my voice, but this example is a car showroom. What happens is every time you go to another scene, a narration starts, and then there's also a background music other than that. So I'm gonna play it here. So we're gonna, I always, when I create a tour with voice, I always give the users a choice, because sometimes I find it irritating when I toggle through tabs and I don't know where the sound is coming from. So at least if you do this, you're giving the user permission to add the sound, and they know where to, what tab to get back to when they want to turn it off. So start with voiceover.
GAC Motor, known as Guangzhou Automotive Group Co. Limited, is one of the top-ranking automotive brands in China. With its 66 years of manufacturing excellence, GAC Motor has produced quality, safe, and innovative vehicles.
So as you can see, I added some toggles here. So this toggles the background music. Well, it restarts it. And this toggles the narration.
GAC Motor, known as...
So I'll just turn this. Well, I'll turn them back on.
GAC Motor, welcome to the GAC showroom. Here you can see the best selection of luxurious and premium quality. The top of the GS8 variants, GS8 GL is the brand's. Welcome to the GAC showroom. Here.
Anyway, you get that part. I'll share a link to this later on. And here's another virtual tour where I put sound. So same, start with music, start without. So there's a background music. The narration or the talking voice is found in the artworks, not in the scenes. So when I click here, a voice starts talking.
Confluence is a mural that speaks about the many factors that shape nationhood and the collective identity. The artist Neil Manalo has the moniker Winningest Artist, both for his family name and for having...
So this one I added the stop play. Anyway, let's begin. I will stop this high face. And okay, where do we start? I'll just drag my windows here. These are our images. I'll just delete this because this is the one where the output where I drag them to Vitor. So here for the MG, they provided me with MP3 files. This came from the client, but we had to resize them. So take note of the sizes. If, well, this one is a sound of a chicken, which we'll use to test later. But these are the actual MP3 files I used for that tour. We had to resize this by reducing the bitrate. So it's, we put it to 70. I don't know why this one is 96, but you have to keep this down. Depends on when you are, where you are. I mean, in the Philippines, where I live, internet is slower. So take that into consideration. There are online tools for that. I'm not sure which one you used, but you can use free ones just to. And where do you find somebody to do the voice? In this case, the client provided me those, but if you need to provide them yourselves, you can look for voice artists in Fiverr. So voice over. So yeah, they can give you the MP3, etc. Okay, so how do we start? So let's start with this, and the size, the usual, I think these are 6K. I do 8K now because screens are much larger, but I did it a year, 2 years ago, I think. So drag to make Vitor, make sure this is multi-res. Okay, I'll pause for now and resume when it's done. So it's almost done. You'll see a Vitor folder here. First thing I do an edit tour. Set the startup view, add some hotspots. This always how I start creating a tour, from make Vitor, and then I just edit a lot of XML files. Goes to the service section. Start position, add hotspot, going to the main showroom. Oh no, here. Going to the supply area, parts area. And then going back to the showroom. Okay, save. And then this should have been edited. Vitor, so you see a backup file, because every time you save that it produces this file. I'm just gonna open Sublime. Okay, then drag this project here. So where do we begin? So this is our virtual tour. Oh, by the way, you will notice the look of your tour might be different because I already have defaults changed in my local computer. So this is always false. When I start it, this is true. Might be false in, on your side, true on mine, and other stuff. But that's the only difference. We should have the same almost if you downloaded the 1.20.11 version. Okay, what do we do next? Look up care panel sound. Sound interface. So you can see a chunk of code here. So when you view the plugins, you can find that file. It's already there. Sound interface. Interface. So we need to insert that. Oh, where are we? We're lost. Let's just do it in Scheme Vitor. Let's do everything here at the bottom. So just sound stuff. Goes here. Okay, let's copy that. And then change this to I use Keret XML now. Because SWF path has been deprecated, I believe. Even this is useless now. Because there's only HTML5. There's no more Flash. That will still work. I'll to be sure do this. But I think it's the same. Okay. So that just means we're... just added the sound interface. I'm gonna transfer the audio files to a folder inside Vitor. Call it audio. Okay, let's test if this present break. I'm just gonna open tour testing server. See some errors. What's happening? It's not working right away. Let me pause this. Okay, so what I did wrong, I don't know why this broke this. This should be plugins. Okay, let's try that again. Okay. Let's turn on debugging. Console log, so we know what's happening. Go back here. F12. Ignore this. This is something on my local, like a Chrome plugin. Well, the one I use for recording. So I don't see any errors. So, okay, so what we're gonna do is per scene, we're gonna play an audio. The way I'm gonna do it is I'm gonna add a sound, well, an attribute per scene to contain like information regarding the MP3 file to play. So here I put a sound URL like this. And it's gonna say like the file that we want to play. So current XML. audio/asa.mp3 and then repeat for the others. So this one is showroom, this is service center, warehouse. Let's check the file names. Showroom, okay, this one is this service center. This one is the service center scene. Service center. And then here, warehouse. So this is not gonna do anything. And actually, this sound URL, I just invented this. There is no sound URL attribute in Carapano. So this can be anything. This can be sound file URL or whatever you want. Just remember that name and then call it later on. So next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna create a play, like an action to play that in Vitor skin, and let's look for on new pano. So this is the event that gets fired every time a new pano loads. So I'm gonna create, add like an action to call here called play audio, and then I'm gonna put at the bottom that action. For now, let's do a trace. Playing audio. And see if it gets called. Here, playing audio. As you can see here. Okay. What's next? So instead of just outputting a text, we are gonna play the audio file assigned to the scene. So to do that, so remember we did this. So to get this, we do this. So this returns the scene. If you do this, so let's trace that. As you can see, and then in order to get an attribute from a scene, we do this and then the name. For example, this one. So if I hard code this, I am able to get the sound URL like that. So if I do this, it's gonna return, well, do a trace again. Trace, and insert that in the middle. It's always gonna return the one for the facade. I'm just showing an example. So it's always facade. So next thing we do is instead of putting facade here, we change it with the variable, I mean the current scene. So we are now able to get the right file. Okay, so let's assign that to a variable, set. Okay, set variable name, let's call it sound file, comma, and then assign it to this. So, and then let's check if that value is correct. I'm gonna look for this. Get, oh, trace, then get sound file. So you don't get confused. Let's play this file. So to play sound, you can find it here. Play sound. I'm gonna use this play sound. Play a sound. Okay. Then you assign a name to it, which you can use to call it later. So play sound. I'm gonna call it voice. And then we do a get sound file, same as this line here, and this is, I believe, a repeat. So if this is true, it will repeat. Okay, let's try this.
GAC Motor, known as Guangzhou Automotive Group Co. Limited, is one of the top-ranking automotive brands in China. With its 66 years of manufacturing excellence, GAC Motor has produced
It's too loud. There's a volume here. I'm gonna reduce this because I'm gonna get deaf soon.
Quality, safe, and...
So, it's not working.
GAC Motor,
here,
known as Guangzhou Automotive Group Co.
Still too loud for me.
Limited is... GAC Motor, known as Guang.
Sorry, I'm just gonna make this point one just for the purpose of this tutorial, so I can hear myself. GAC Motor, so as you can see, when I do a refresh, GAC Motor, you don't hear.
GAC Motor, known as.
How do you explain this?
GAC Motor, GAC Motor.
So you need an action.
GAC Motors warehouse.
Actually, wait.
Wide array of genuine car accessories.
Here it is. There is no sound, right? Because I saw this explained somewhere. There needs to be some sort of action before the audio gets played. And it's just the way I think browsers work as a security thing or whatever. So it's a feature. So now when I move my mouse, the audio starts playing. Let me try to search where they talked about that. Sound doesn't play right away. I think somebody will answer here that it's... I'm not sure where I saw that. But yeah, that's just the way it works. But we're gonna do a workaround later. We're gonna do an intro screen. Okay, so where are we? We're playing sound every time, and then what we're gonna do next, I'm gonna add a button toggle here. And what I'm gonna do is use already an existing one here. So let's use these buttons here. Okay. So I'm just gonna. Where is that? So Vitor skin, you'll find some buttons here. So here, button. Of course, I already know where it is. Let me just look for my cheat sheet. So it is beside this button hide that we're gonna put it. So I'm gonna copy this and call it button toggle voice. Same. And this one, these are the coordinates. We'll get into that later. This, I'm gonna do a 130 from the right pixels. And then, here, we're gonna call an action called toggle voice, which is non-existent yet. So, how do we know the crop? So, this is, how do I explain this? Let me open up Photoshop.
Guarantee its customers are not.
Kaya paano crop? Let's look for it. Crop. So, left, right, top, bottom. So, let's say we have this image. Where are you? Let's open that. So, this is 128 to 128. So, half would be 64. So, let's do 64 by 64. Just as an example. I'm gonna make this red. Okay, I'm just doing this to show you. So this is 0 0. If we do a 0 0 here, 0 0 64, so XY means 0 0, and 64 means 64 height. So that doesn't make sense, because that is a, what is that, the cardboard icon. If we do a Y value of 64, then it's gonna move here. Let's try that just to show you. So this is X, let's do 64 here. And
high quality vehicles, GAC Motor has built a world-class supply chain system that helped the brand.
It's irritating now.
There's the industry leading.
Can I just mute you? Or 0.05, shut up voice.
Standards for vehicle.
Okay.
GAC Motor,
so this here, this wasn't here a while ago. So right now we're gonna try to find the, like, the coordinates of this one. So let's do a math. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So here times 10. So 64 times 10. We don't need the calculator for that, but just to make sure. So where are you? Toggle. Do a 640. Oh, sorry. Here, 640. That should change this icon here. So it's now a play icon. And we don't have a toggle voice yet. Let's add a toggle voice. Toggle voice. Okay, what does this do? It toggles a voice. Okay, so I'm just reviewing what I did. So I checked a condition. So if you don't know, this is an if else in Kirarpan. So that's the format. So I check if the sound named voice is playing or paused. So if this is null, it means it is not playing. So if it's not playing, we do a play audio, which we already have here on top. Just delete that. But if it is not null, that means it's currently playing. So we do a toggle sound and the name of the sound. We should find that here. Toggle. Oh no. Music. Okay. So toggle sound name. Either pause or resume sound. So I'm toggling it and I'm doing a switch on the button. So okay, let me show you what happens now. Plays audio, pauses it, plays it. But the icon doesn't change, right? So we do a toggle, a switch. So this is a KR Pano action. KR Pano. Let's see. Switch. KR Pano actions. Switch. So yeah. Switches the value of the given variable between through several states. Okay. So toggle voice, cause toggle voice is being called by this button. So if we put crop here, that means the crop of the button. So we are changing the crop value. So we're changing the crop value of this one here. Every time we click on that, and what we do is change it to this one and this one. Sorry, this is 64. So that means what we're doing is move this one here. So we're doing this and this. So we're toggling between these two. So 0, 64, 0, 64, and Y is always 640. Okay. Frankie Automotive Brands, GAC Motor. No. Oh,
it's working!
It's working! Okay, what's next? Okay, let me check my notes. Okay, so what I did next was, so what happens if the audio finishes? For testing, so as you remember, I had a test sound here. It's a sound of a chicken. So I'll play it for you. So because we need a quick audio to test when it's finished. So for now, this will be a sound of a chicken. The test. Or let's just call it chicken so that we don't get confused what is the test. So the test is chicken. So what we want to do is every time an audio finishes, this should also change, right? So it's still, this is a wrong icon now. See, okay, what we do. So here, so on play audio, so let's on play audio we change the crop to the playing, so we're sure, right? So here we do player skin button toggle voice dot crop. Then assign it to the playing icon 64, cause that means it is showing this, the plus icon, right? Cause it's playing. Why we didn't do crop here, cause usually we just do this, right? It's because play audio is not being called from an on click of a button, so we need to put layer and skin button the name, which is this one. So we're changing the crop. And then same in here. So there is another, what you call this, a parameter here. on finished, I think. So after loop on complete, see this one. So what do we do? A code to call when the sound is fully played. We do a on voice finished. So this gets called when the audio is finished. So we create another action called on voice finished, and then for now we just do a trace. Finished. So every time the chicken is done, it says it's gonna do a finished. Okay. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna change the icon when that is finished. How do you do that? So we already did that here. So just add that here and change this to 0. Goes back to play. Then I can play this again. Okay, let's proceed to another. So this will take a while. And then when this audio finishes, this will change to play. Let me just pause it for you so that it's faster. Oh shit. I didn't play in time that it's about to finish. But yeah, as you can see, chase to play button. Okay, what's next? Reviewing my notes. Sedans, SUVs, and minivans, GAC Motor prides itself on years of manufacturing high efficiency, high quality, and world class automobiles. Play? Okay. So the next thing I did. Well, actually, from here on, this is already a decent, I mean, tour with sounds. But what I did next was, I didn't play the audio file if the user has already heard it. Because it's kind of irritating, right? Like, I already heard this, then I move here, then it plays again. It's actually irritating now. So, what I did next was I added a variable per scene, and I called it sound finished. So again, I just invented this attribute. This doesn't exist in Garapano. It's just a flag, a bully, just to let us know if, you know, the user has already heard this and heard the entire MP3. So sound finished. Then what did I do with sound finished? Okay, so on new panel, we're gonna replace this with play audio if not finished. So I think it's straightforward what this does. It plays the audio if it's not yet finished or if the user hasn't heard it before. So let's create an action here. And just add some checking. So what do? We check that variable again. Remember how we did it here? Where we got a sound file. So this is almost the same, except it's sound finished. You can see the best selection of luxurious. Let's try what happens. So it's always gonna be false, right? False. Cause let's see if it's getting the correct values. Let's do true here just to check. And everything else should be false. So true, false. So it's getting the right values. So I'm gonna put this in a variable, call it is finished. Okay. And then I'm gonna check if is finished is done. So if is finished equals false. I don't think I need to explain this, but basically if is finished is false, the code goes here. If it's not false, it goes here. So it's an if else if. Paano? Wrong page. Anyway, so if it's finished, don't do anything, right? Is finished false. It's finished false. Play audio. Yeah, right. You have to play because it's finished, right? Is that right? Is finished. Wait. Let me analyze this again. Okay, that seems correct. Is finished is false. User has not heard it yet, so play the audio. But if the user has already heard it, then pause the sound, which is voice. And then let's change the button again to the play. Because it's paused, so change to this one. So I'm gonna remove this so that you understand why we're doing that. So here, place the chicken. Oh, what happened? I did the true, false, sound finished. Okay, let me see what happened here. Oh, sorry, it was working. I just forgot about the movement, right? So, well, actually, it's not working. I mean, but the tour is working. So what we forgot was, so we need to, so we have a on voice finished, right? So when the voice is finished, we set the sound finished to false, to true. So how do we do that? Set and just use this sound finished. We're setting this value and then setting it to true. So when the chicken is finished, this becomes true. Then when I try to click it again, it won't play anymore. Try to click this one, so it's not playing anymore. Well, it tried to pause the sound, which doesn't exist, so we can ignore that. But it is, as you can see, the play button still works. So I think I added this one. So here, turns out it's not required, but I'm just checking my code. I added the so this one here, just to make sure. Yes, I added a return to the play button. So this isn't really required, but I don't know why I put it here in the first place. So what is next? So let's see. Okay, move to the next.
Welcome to the GAC show.
Then I can toggle this. Oh, I added, forgot to add the hotspot here. So the issue now, when I refresh the virtual tour, sometimes the audio doesn't play automatically. Because it requires a user interaction on the virtual tour. What to solve that? I do a welcome screen. So here, I trigger the start of the audio from a welcome screen. So let's add a welcome screen here. I'm gonna call it intro, and it is a container. Keep through. Width 100%. It's gonna cover everything. Height 100%. Background alpha around 0.8, 0.9. Background color black 0x 1 2 3 4 5 6. Enabled true, that means it can be clicked. PG capture true. Z order on top of everything 999, and hand cursor false. Hand cursor. Let's see what happens. So we have the black screen. We have to. I'm gonna have to stop that chicken from playing. So to do that, I added a variable. Intro done. Where did I put it? So here, there's a skin startup. Oh no, here. Here, skin startup. So this gets called only once. And yeah, I added a, just looking for it. Set intro done here. Intro done. What does this do? So I'm checking if the user has already clicked the button, like to start the tour before I play any audio. So I add check now to. So here we had a play audio, if not finished action. I'm just gonna add a new check. Intro done. Oh, intro done. Okay. I'm checking my old code. I did an underscore. So here, I check intro done equals true. And is finished. So in order for the audio to play, the intro has to be already done, and what is finished is false, so the chicken won't play. Okay, what do we do next? We add some design elements. I'm just gonna copy some text I already have ready. So this is like a heading and a subheading. Okay, then we add the buttons here. Okay, we just copy and pasting now. Okay, on click. So we have a button. Let's see. So I'm doing some really shortcut stuff. So we have the button, start with voiceover. When you click it, the intro done is set to true, and it plays the audio and disables this the intro, this one. So disable, we don't have this yet. So I need to create this. And what does this do? We just set the layer of the layer we're interested in changing to false, and we hide it by twin. Twinning the alpha of that layer. We change it to 0. And then when it's done, we change the layer's visibility to false. So, disabled. So we don't have the style yet, so this doesn't exist. So you won't see anything here, I think. Okay, so we need to style it. This create style name button primary of button primary. Okay, yeah, it's a type text. My position. Probably that don't need this. We need to add a padding. Oops. Ah! Let's add a background color first. BG color. It's red. Add the padding. 10, 20, this is top, bottom, this is left, right, and then we add a border, 1 pixel I think, and same color, forgot what this third value is, let's see if this works. Okay, so we add the round edge. BG round edge. 4. And then change the text color to white by doing some CSS stuff. This can be 6 or 3. They accept both. Okay, so there you go. When you click this, an audio starts. Okay, let me change that back to not the chicken sound, which is sad. So what happens? So when we start the tour, so on XML, on new panel, let's do on new panel. Play audio if not finished this code. So let's do a trace here. Play audio not finished. And then let's do a trace here. Play audio. And here, pause audio. Fresh. So the code went to pause audio, but since you haven't played voice yet, it can't find it. So this is just a warning, so it's fine. So when you click this, we call these actions. What you do is we set intro done to true, so just an indicator that the user has already finished looking at the intro, and then we play audio, and then we disable the intro, and from that point on, intro is done, will always be done, intro done will always be true, and whenever it goes to this play audio not finished, this is no longer an issue because this will always be true, and we're just checking the is finished variable.
GAC Motor, known as Guangzhou Automotive Group Co. Limited, is one of the top-ranking automotive brands in China. With its 66 years of manufacturing excellence, GAC Motor has produced quality, safe, and innovative vehicles. To guarantee its customers with high-quality vehicles, GAC Motor has built a world-class supply chain system that helped the brand establish the industry-leading standards for vehicle parts and component quality.
Let's wait for it to finish.
Effort, GAC Motor has been recognized as the top Chinese brand by J.D. Power Asia Pacific for 8 consecutive years.
It's so dull.
GAC Motor was officially launched in the country under the exclusive distributorship of Legato Motors, Inc. With the ongoing demand for passenger vehicles and positive market feedback,
please stop.
GAC Motor will continue to introduce its first-class models in the Philippine market and deliver exceptional customer service to Philippine
motorists. Breathe! The guy is running out of breath. Okay. When the audio finished, the play button finished. So when I click this, this shouldn't play anymore. Yeah, so because we said that the sound finish is true, but we need, so no longer playing. But if I click play, it will still play. So when I go inside, the audio will play. Because the user hasn't heard this yet. Okay, so this one is much faster, just a few seconds. Let's wait for it to finish.
High efficiency, high quality, and world-class automobiles.
So it's done. So when you click on these thumbnails, the audio won't play anymore because we've already heard it. Yeah, I think we're done. Another thing you can do is add another background music, another sound, which is the background music. We can do that. I just didn't prepare it, but okay, let me just pause and ready those files. So I'm just gonna wing it because I didn't have it in the finished tour. So we have background music here. It's here already. So what do we do? It's confusing. Debug messages. So I'm gonna create a new one called play music. And then what it's gonna do is play a sound file, which is always one file since it won't change. It's just always the background. I'm gonna call it music. And here, bgmusic.mp3. Current XML. Current XML. Play music. Okay, let's try it. So, when the user clicks here, I'm gonna play the music. See if that works. Okay, that's working. But when you pause this, it's not included. And I believe we can assign a volume to this because it's quite loud. Let me look forward at this. Sound volume, play sound. So when you play sound, you can assign a volume. So loop pulse volume. So after on complete, so let's do 0.1. Let's try that.
GAC Motor, known as Guangzhou Automotive Group Co. Limited, is one of the top-ranking automotive brands in China. Within 66 years,
so you want to add another toggle here, maybe for that. Let's just use this as an example. So this is like the play and the pause. Oh my god, stop. So let's go for that scheme button, toggle voice. Let's add another one here called toggle music. Well, for now, let's just use the same icon. Okay, let's use the icon at the bottom. So 640 plus 64, that would be 704. And we move by how much? How much did they move it by? 120 pixels? Okay, let's try 160.
for GAC. GAC Motor, known as Guangzhou Automotive Group Co.
More?
Is one of the top automotive brands in China. With its
GAC actually, Motor, that's confusing. Let's just use 6.
One of the top ranking automotive brands in China. With its
so, just for this tutorial, this is for the background music, and this is for the narration. Okay, so when we play... Okay, stop. So when we play the music, we also change the crop, right? Play music, toggle music. And we change this to the other one. Wait, my voice the zero value. Okay, let's try that.
To guarantee GAC Motor,
so this should have been pause. What did we do wrong?
With its 66 years of manufacturing excellence, GAC
zero.
Motor
oh, this should be 64.
GAC Motor, known as Guangzhou Automotive Group called
Lip. So that's wrong, because this should be toggling the background music. So, toggle music. Bimpa. Should we do a toggle music here? Still playing. Toggle music. So we do the same except we call that sound file music. So here, play sound music. So this one here. If it's paused, then play music. If it not, if it's not, then we toggle music and we switch to crop. Okay, so that should do it.
GAC Motor, known as Guangzhou Automotive Group called.
So I was able to pause the music independently. And here pause the audio. So I'm gonna play the music now. So it is unaffected even if we switch through scenes. So it's the background music still playing. So what else can you do later on? You can change the icons, add music and cancel music icons, put it here, and just change the crop XY values. Yeah, that's about it. Thank you for watching, and yeah. Goodbye.